Hey guys, I just want to let you know on some really dope spoilers. So in case you guys missed it, I want to point these things out to you. And no, I'm not talking about Spider-Man No Way Far From Home, which I was really happy to see, but no spoilers. Anyway, this is actually spoilers for things you might have missed for Raleigh NC for things to do this winter. Now there's actually a really dope bar, first one right off the bat, the Willow. It's in downtown Raleigh on Glenwood on top of the Marriott on the 7th floor. It's amazing for sunset views, just opened up during COVID. But it has a really nice fireplace for winter time. I just really love the views. Me and my friend went there one night, check it out, have some good hangs, take some shots. I mean, we're kind of like sunset, sunrise buddies. If we ever just want to come hang out, we just, it's like, hey, you want to go see a sunset? Yeah, yeah. Or, you gonna wake up tomorrow at 6 a.m. and go see the sunrise at the airport? And then next up, we have, of course, downtown Raleigh. I know, big surprise. But during the wintertime, they have those three amazing Christmas trees. Downtown is fully lit up, different Christmas stuff. And at the same time, this is like the second year they've done Raleigh, the Illuminated Art Walk. So they have various different, about 15 or so different neon or illuminated art pieces that are done by local artists. So definitely really fun to just check it out by yourself or go with someone and just go downtown and be amazed. And then last but not least, and that one is here until about January 2nd or 3rd. I'll leave information down below. And last but not least, we have the exhibit at Dorothea Dix, which is Wings of the City by Jorge Marin. It's an international exhibit by a Mexican artist, and it's about 9 different bronze pieces that are scattered throughout. And it says Wings of the City because there's this amazing shot of these like really big wings, and I know it's different for every city, but this spot for this city is amazing because it's right behind Raleigh. Like at the placement, you stand behind it and there's literally Wings of the City, so Raleigh is right behind it. I know it's weird saying it, but it's amazing placement. They did a great job in that. Looks fun, Mom. Looks phenomenal. I went with another friend of mine, Dylan, and I was thinking, you know what? I was really obsessed with Money Heist or La Casa de Papel, so I bought the suit recently, and I was like, hey, it'll be really dope if I had the wings behind it, you know, kind of symbolic, like, you know, long live the revolution and all that. So we took a few pics in that. Other than that, you'll see at the end. So yeah, those are 3 different things, and I'm about to highlight it in this quick little recap, and I'll see you at the end. hope you guys are able to check out those dope spots this season. And remember, the Willard is here all the time, but the other two are kind of seasonal per se, so go check it out while you still can. And the few black and white shots that I have, I actually didn't download all the files from the zip. I mean, I do have the film strip, which is good, but I shot it on Wolfman 35 on my Olympus stylus. And then the other shots that were in color were on Lomography 800, and it was on my Canon 81. So I hope you guys enjoyed that just as much as I did, and love sharing that with you guys. And if you love that, feel free to stick around for some more stuff like that. And I do have another recap. Hopefully I get the film back from the lab to show you some more Christmas shots that I took, hopefully soon. If not, and if this is the last time I see you until the next time, I mean, if no one says this yet or before, whatever. Just want to wish you guys a Merry Christmas, Happy Holiday, and Happy New Year. I know this past 2 years has been crazy for all of us, but we will get through it. Wish I could hug everybody or give everybody gifts, but, you know, I'm not really Saint Nick, not that magical. But if you do need a little smile or something, I am magical in that way, so if you need a little cheering, feel free to hit me up on Instagram or something, and I'll see what I can do. Try to brighten your day. If not, I'll see you in the next one. Thank you guys for tuning in, and yeah, it's been a great one. Great 2021. Time for 2022. See you.